sometimes that's half the battle to be up for.
It's another missed field, and it was a tight run had there not been a missed field. And because of the direct hit, there'll be buzzers. Or a buzzer. End of the fifth, it's been an eventful five, 43 for two.
Not a straightforward ground to bowl spin, though, is it? Well, mid-off is deep, and Bairstow is quick.
No!
Well, that's a good over. Well, might be two. No, over does well. England dealing with singles at the minute. They will want more. Does go leg side and goes into the gap all the way for six. Lovely way for Bairstow and England to end the seventh. 59 for two. Disgusted with himself. Hit hard, sounded sweet. I think the fielder lost it. I think the fielder lost it because he sort of bailed out the last minute and it went over the fence at catchable height.
Hit hard and flat from Bairstow. He comes running in as the back pedal and just there loses it. Loses it.
Happy with the single. Here to end the eighth, 73 for two.
Yes, 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 yes.
Well, that's good for South Africa. That's good for Maharaj, only the single, so he's got one ball to get out of the over. Hit hard into the gap, skip away for four.
Yeah, better cricket from Jonny Bairstow. Rocks onto the back foot and picks his gap to perfection. More of a drag down from Shamsi, he's certainly under pressure at the moment.
Goes again, this time deliberately lifts it high and handsomely into the crowd. Excellent batting from Jonny Bairstow.
That's a huge drag down. Bit of a pie, actually. Bairstow tucks into it. He's not going to miss out on something like that, even if it is to the long side.
Drag down again, gets away with it. 19 from the 10th over, England 94 for two.
Yeah, I actually think England are on top now. I just think Shamsi is now struggling. He hasn't found a rhythm.
Oh.
A bit of a swipe from Bairstow.
Oh.
That's a nice change up from Maharaj. That's pretty good thinking.
Jonny Bairstow says, okay, good over, we'll let you have it. He'll keep the strike for the 12th over, England 101 for two.
Talk about matchups these days, I think this would be the matchup. Milan short boundary. I think David Miller sensing this could be an opportunity to maybe go bang bang, gets his key strike bowler.
Yeah. Yeah.
Little fumble means they can come back for two. It's short. Not quite short enough. Been good this from Shamsi. There's that short ball. And there it goes. Getting the ball full enough and not getting hit back over your head for six. Not dragging it down, but Bairstow's just sitting back.
Person you can turn to, because someone often does have an off day. Shamsi's struggling today. 3 overs, 0-49. You talked about Stubbs, but
right ball. Great call, very good. Okay. Yes.
Yep.
50 for Jonny Bairstow. His miraculous summer continues.
Yeah, superb innings, 50 off 36 deliveries, four sixes and a boundary strike rate of just under 140.
Oh. Aye.
And straight he goes into the crowd, flat, hard, another six.
To an in Jonny Bairstow. He's tried a Yorker again and just missed his length.
High in the air. Should be out. Oh, down it goes. Riley Russo, I think, coming in from the deep. That should have been taken. And Bairstow gets a life. Stubbs won't be happy.
It's the second catch of the night that's gone down. And it's Jonny Bairstow again.
A real snatch, that, from Riley Russo in the deep. As Bairstow pummels another into the leg side, to the short side. That is a big hit. And he starts his 17th over with a six.
Fielders are talking to the two drop catches, huh? So you see Jonny Bairstow going to the short side. Huge change in momentum in the previous over from Stubbs.
Oh, that sounded sweet. And my, that is a big hit. That's gone all the way over the back of the stand and into the car park. And Bairstow starts with a brace of sixes.
Lethlequeo just straying straight into the middle of his bat and out of the ground.
Wide. It's another wide. You can see what he's trying to do. He's trying to keep it away from that short leg side and play to the longer side. Gone this time. Oh no, I don't believe it. Cannot believe it. Bairstow has been put down again. Maybe the easiest catch of the three.
Lethlequeo staying wide and slow. Bairstow had given up. Dolly, oh, it's gone straight in, out in again, and then hit the deck.
Starts with a full toss. Bairstow helps it away to the leg side, four.
Low full toss, and Giddy going for that cross seam Yorker. Bairstow doesn't get much of it, but good enough here.
Bairstow one-handed, another one goes down. Klassen in the deep. This was tough. This was a much tougher chance, but it was a chance. It did carry.
Definitely a tougher chance here for South Africa. Bairstow threw the shot, but gets enough on it to get it to Klassen again. Just cannot grasp it.
Slower ball again, another excellent slower ball. He bowls it so well. There are very few batsmen who cotton onto the way that Ngidi bowls that slower ball. Excellent Yorker to start from Rabada. Yeah, that's where the impetus really came. Bairstow clubs away to the leg side and into the crowd. He moves to 89.
Climbs into it when it's sat up. It's a leg cutter. Sitting deep in the crease.
Brilliant from Rabada. He started the over with a fantastic yorker, and that one just as good.
Deception in the ball you're bowling. Choosing to bowl a yorker, every delivery can sometimes be predictable.
Gets away with a high-ish full toss, certainly not a no ball, but one that Bairstow might have fancied clubbing into the crowd as well. 19 done. Oh, it's gone high. It's gone very high, but it's not far enough. And this time, Riley Russo takes the catch, a tumbling catch, a good one in the end, has the figures of 5 for 39. He's got one ball left. This was his fifth wicket, with Riley Russo coming in from the deep as he did previously, and in the end settled himself and took a good catch. But 5 for 39, in the context of what we've seen, excellent figures for Ngidi, and another wonderful exhibition from Bairstow.